What did the Russians do to manipulate our voting on this unbelievably weak country? Its democracy was threatened by Russian ads on Facebook or whatever it is that they were alleged to have done. Oh, Russian ads. Whoa, manipulating. Oh, the president, he tried to change the election. I am curious. Let us say, and I don't know this for a fact, I'm making a supposition. Let us suppose, that's what a supposition is. Suppose is the verb, supposition is the noun. Let us suppose that American policy toward Ukraine was influenced by the fact that the son of the vice president of the United States was being paid by a Ukrainian company large sums of money while he was vice president. Is that illegal or immoral for the president of the United States to ask that country to look into it? Question number two. Let us say that Joe Biden had not announced that he was a candidate to run for president of the United States, or at least candidate to get the nomination of the Democratic Party to be president of the United States. Would the president's acts then have been okay? The constant refrain is he used a foreign government to manipulate the election. Let us say Joe Biden were not running, and it was simply a desire to uncover something very bad. If it happened, I'm not saying it did, but it is worthy of looking into, especially given that same Joe Biden boasted that he had gotten rid of the Ukrainian prosecutor who looked into corruption. So is that not worthy of looking into? Does that threaten American democracy? Is that a grievous, that's the word that Mitt Romney used to Chris Wallace. Is that a grievous violation of the Constitution? We have cheapened the word impeachment and we have cheapened the word grievous. It's really quite remarkable. The Never Trumpers, who I read constantly, their inability to see the big picture is just, it puzzles me. But they're in a bad position, the Never Trumpers, because he's turned out to be a magnificent president policy-wise. And policy, frankly, is pretty important. My policies are less important because I don't control much of the world, as the United States doesn't control much of the world. Effects, let's put it that way, effects. But his due, just on his weakening of the most awful threat in the world at this time, Iran, for that alone, the man deserves such respect. We had a what was the word? Somebody said to me, I'm a Trump bootlicker. That's amazing. Because it's a word that frankly does come to mind with the appeasers of the Iranian government. And I won't use the term, but that's the one that came to mind. So did I use it or not? I don't want to fool around with you. So if I used it, I used it. But it is a terrible appeasing of the Iranian regime that took place by this country under the Obama administration. Well, the Never Trumpers continue. It's to me, see, it's so interesting. It's like Mitt Romney. There is a desire, which is commendable. There is a desire in a lot of these people to feel proud of their moral backbone. And by the way, That's a good thing to feel proud of your moral backbone. But if being proud of your moral backbone trumps the question, what is good for America, then that's the issue as I see it with these people, from Romney to Jonah Goldberg and others. Their commendable desire to be proud of their moral backbone trumps the question of whether the man is doing good for the country. That is more important to me than thinking well of myself, of being proud of my moral backbone. Good for vast numbers of people is a moral issue. If you really care about your moral backbone, what's a more moral question than is the sum total of the man's presidency good? How does this compare in terms of good and bad, moral and not moral, to there being a Democratic president, in this case Hillary Clinton, but as far as I'm concerned, it is irrelevant. They are completely interchangeable. When the press calls Buttigieg a moderate, it is because they want him elected. It is a joke. It's a complete joke. This is very important. There's something noble about wanting to be proud of your moral backbone. But it is not all that admirable if that trumps the greater moral question of is good being done?